Hi students, welcome back. Today I am discussing problems related with work energy power. Our first question: a body of mass 20 kg at rest is acted upon simultaneously by two forces 6 newton and 8 newton at right angles to each other. Okay, two forces which are acting on a 20 kg body. Two forces which are acting on a 20 kg body, and these two forces are at right angles to each other. Okay, these two forces F1 and F2 are at right angles to each other. Then kinetic energy at the end of 10 seconds of it starts. We want to find out what about the kinetic energy of the system. Okay, from the given data, we can find out what about the resultant of these two forces. Okay, here the forces which are acting at right angles to each other. Then what about the resultant force? Resultant force Fr is equal to root of F1 square plus F2 square. Okay, because these two forces which are acting perpendicular to each other or at right angles. That's equal to root of 6 square plus 8 square, which is equal to root of 36 plus 64. That's equal to root 100. It's equal to 10. Okay. 10 newton is the force which is acting on that body. Resultant force which is acting on that body is equal to 10 newton. Okay. Then according to the law of motion, F is equal to ma. We can write acceleration A is equal to F divided by M. Then F is equal to 10 newton and mass M. M is equal to 20 kg. Then it's equal to 0.5. Okay. 0.5 meter per second square is the acceleration of this mass. Now, what about velocity? We want to find out the kinetic energy of the system. Equation for the kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. Now, we want to find out what about the velocity. Okay. Then, from here, we can write acceleration A is equal to velocity divided by time. Then, velocity V is equal to acceleration into time. That's equal to acceleration 0.5 into what about the time given here? Time T is equal to 10 seconds. Okay. Time T is equal to 10 seconds. That's equal to 5. 0.5 into 10, that's equal to 5 meter per second is the velocity. Okay, 5 meter per second is the velocity of that body. Okay, now it's very easy to find out what about the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy at the end of 10 seconds, that is kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. Okay, half into M is equal to 20 kg into V square. V is equal to 5. Then V square is equal to 5 into 5, 25. That's equal to 2 cancel to 20. That's 10. It's equal to 250. Okay. 250 joule is the kinetic energy possessed by that body. Okay. Our second question. A body of mass 30 kg is moving along a rough horizontal surface of coefficient of friction 0.5. Okay. Here, the body is having a mass 30 kg which is moving along a rough horizontal surface. Okay. At that instant, its speed is found to be 10 meter per second. Speed of that body is found to be 10 meter per second. Then the rate of loss of kinetic energy at that instant is. Okay, rate of change of kinetic energy means rate of doing work. Work is equal to energy. According to work energy theorem, work is equal to change in kinetic energy. Then rate of change of kinetic energy means rate of doing work. Therefore, we can say that power is equal to rate of doing work is known as power. Power is equal to F dot B. Okay. Now, what about the force which is acting on that body? Okay. To find out the force which is acting on that body, this body of mass 30 kg which is placed on a horizontal rough surface. Then frictional force which is acting just opposite to the direction of movement. If this body is moving with a velocity in this direction, then frictional force which is acting just opposite to the movement of the body. Okay. Mg is the weight of the body which is acting downward. Okay, then reaction which is acting normal to the body. Okay, then according to the law of friction, we can say that frictional force is equal to mu into reaction R. That's equal to mu into whatever reaction R is balanced by Mg. Reaction R is balanced by Mg. Therefore, frictional force is equal to mu Mg. Okay. Now, the force is exerting on that body. Okay. So, we can say that frictional force F is equal to the frictional force. Okay. Then, instead of force, we can write mu into Mg. Okay. Dot V. Or V. In magnitude wise, it's equal to V. Okay. Mu Mg into V. We can substitute the value of mu. Mu is equal to 0.5. M is equal to 30 kg. G is taken as 10 into velocity. V is equal to 10 meter per second. That's equal to 0.5 into 10, 5. 5 into 30, 150. 150 into 10, that's equal to 1500. Okay. Power P is equal to 1500. What about its unit? Its unit is watt. Okay. 1500 watt is the power. That's the rate of loss of kinetic energy at this instant. Okay. Next question. A body of mass 40 kg is moved along an inclined plane of inclination 30 degree to the horizontal through a distance of 2 meter. Okay. An inclined plane is there. Through that inclined plane, a body of mass 40 kg is moved through a distance of 2 meter. Okay. A 40 kg body is moved through a distance of 2 meter. Okay, 2 meter is the length of this inclined plane. 2 meter. 40 kg body which is moved along this inclined plane. Then the change in potential energy of the body is, we want to find out what about the change in potential energy of the body. Okay, here the inclination is also given. Inclination is equal to 30 degree. Okay. If the inclined plane is having a length is equal to L, okay, inclined plane is having a length L is equal to 2 meter, then which component of L is present here? Okay, or from the trigonometry, we can write, what about sine 30? Sine 30 is equal to opposite sine divided by hypotenuse. Okay, sine 30 is equal to opposite side is this, that can be taken as x divided by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is the length of the inclined plane. Okay, then x is equal to L sine 30. Okay, that's equal to L is equal to 2 meter into sine 30. Sine 30 is equal to 1 by 2. Therefore, it becomes 1. 1 meter is the distance x. Okay, this distance x is also taken as the height of this inclined plane, that's equal to 1 meter. Okay, height of the inclined plane is equal to 1 meter. Then what about the change in potential energy of the body? Okay, to calculate the change in potential energy, what about the initial potential energy? Okay, initial height is equal to 0, therefore the potential energy mgh is equal to 0. Okay, initial potential energy, that's equal to mgh, that's equal to mg into height, h is equal to 0, therefore it's equal to 0. Okay, then what about the final kinetic energy? Final kinetic energy is equal to mg into h, that's equal to mg into, what about the height? Height is equal to, when this body is reached here, okay, height is equal to 1 meter into 1, that's equal to m into g. Okay, what about mass? Mass is equal to 40 into g. G is equal to 10, then it becomes 400 joule. Okay, initial potential energy is equal to 0 joule and final potential energy is equal to 400 joule. Then what about the change in potential energy? Change in potential energy is equal to 400 minus 0, that's equal to 400. Then change in potential energy. Change in potential energy is equal to 400. Okay, 400 joule is the answer. Okay, to solve this problem, what about we? First of all, we want to find out what about the height of this inclined plane. Okay, height of the inclined plane can be find out by trigonometry. Then sine 30 is equal to x divided by opposite side divided by hypotenuse. Then x is equal to L into sine 30. L is 2 meter, that is given in the question. And sine 30 is equal to 1 by 2. Then on cancelling, x is equal to 1 meter. Okay, 1 meter is the height of this inclined plane. Okay, on substituting the value of initial height and final height, we can find out what about the potential energy. Initial height, that is taken as 0, that is at the starting point height is taken as 0, and at this point height is taken as 1 meter. Then what about the change in potential energy? Change in potential energy, we got it as 400 joule. Our next question, a body of mass 20 kg is moved up an inclined plane of inclination 45 degree with a speed of 0.2 meter per second. Okay, speed V is given. Okay, speed V is equal to 0.2 meter per second. Okay, body having mass 20 kg is moved up an inclined plane. Okay, body having 20 kg which is moved up an inclined plane. Okay, angle of inclination here it's equal to 45 degree. M is the mass. Mass M is equal to 20 kg. Okay. If 0.2 is the coefficient of friction, the power is, we want to find out what about the power. Here we want to find out what about the force needed to move up this body. Here weight of the body which is acting vertically downward. Weight of the body can be resolved into two components. Okay. If this angle is equal to 45, this angle is also equal to 45 degree. Then mg cos 45 is here. And here it's equal to mg sin 45. Reaction R is acting normal to the body. Okay. Here the body moves up with a velocity is equal to 0.2 meter per second. Coefficient of friction 0.2 which is given here. So from that we can, it is understood that the surface is rough. So frictional force is acting in the downward direction because the movement of the body is in the upward direction. So frictional force is just opposite to the movement of the body. So frictional force which is acting in the downward direction. Okay, now what are the forces which are acting in the downward direction? Frictional force plus mg sin 45 which are acting in the downward direction. Then how much force is required for the movement of the body in the upward direction, which is equivalent to that of frictional force plus mg sin 45. Okay, a force F is equivalent to frictional force plus mg sin 45 is required for the movement of the body in the upward direction. Okay. So from here, we can write the balanced equation. F is balanced by friction F plus mg sin 45. Then F is equal to frictional force F plus mg sin 45. Okay, what about friction? According to the law of friction, frictional force is equal to mu into reaction R. Reaction R is balanced by mg cos 45. So, mu into mg cos 45 plus mg sin 45. That's equal to mg which is common in both. So, it is taken outside into mu cos 45 plus sin 45. Okay, now we can substitute the values. M is equal to 20, 20 into G, G is equal to 10 into mu, mu is equal to 0.2, cos 45 1 by root 2 plus sin 45 again 1 by root 2, that's equal to 200 into 1 by root 2 is common in both terms, so 1 by root 2 is taken outside into 0.2 plus 1. That's equal to 1.2 into 200 into 1 by root 2. That's equal to 12 into 20, that is equal to 240. 240 divided by root 2. 240 by root 2 is the force acting on that body. That is the minimum force which is acting on that body for the upward move, for its upward motion. Okay. Then what about power? We already said that power P is equal to F dot B, that is equal to FV cos theta. What about theta? Force and velocities are in the same direction. When then theta is equal to 0, then FV is the power. Okay. Force is known, x equal to 240 divided by root 2. 240 divided by root 2 into. What about velocity? Velocity is equal to 0.2. Then it becomes equal to 48 divided by root 2. 48 by root 2, what is the power of the body? Or it can be written as 24 root 2. 24 root 2, what is the power? Okay, required. Okay. Next question. Consider a car moving along a straight horizontal road with a speed of 72 km per hour. Okay. A car moving along a straight horizontal road with a speed V is equal to 72 km per hour. V is equal to 72. We want to convert it into meter per second. Therefore, multiplying it by 5 by 18. Then we got the answer as 20. Okay. 18 cancel to 72, that's equal to 4. Then 5 into 4 is equal to 20. 20 meter per second is the velocity of that body or speed, which is equal to 20 meter per second. If the coefficient of friction between the rod and the tire is given, that is the rod is frictional. Okay. The coefficient of friction between them is taken as 0.3. Mu is equal to 0.3. That's also given. Then the shortest distance in which the car can be stopped is. We want to find out what about the distance in which this car can be stopped. Okay. For this, we can take M is the mass of the car. Then Mg is the weight of the car which is acting downward. Reaction which is acting upward. Okay. The car moves with a velocity V is equal to 20 meter per second in the forward direction. Okay. The car moves with a velocity is equal to 20 meter per second in the forward direction. So, there will frictional force which is acting just opposite to the movement of the body. Okay. Frictional force which is acting just opposite to the movement of the body. If the acceleration of the car is taken in the forward direction. Okay. Here the car accelerates in the forward direction with an acceleration A. Then the force corresponding to that acceleration is equal to M into A. These are the forces which are acting on that body of mass M. Okay. And by balancing the equation, we can write F is equal to MA. Frictional force F is equal to MA. And also according to the law of friction, frictional force is equal to mu into reaction. Mu into reaction is equal to MA. Mu into reaction, R is balanced by the weight of the body. Then mu into Mg is equal to MA. MM get cancelled. Then acceleration A is equal to mu into G. Okay. What about the acceleration of the system? Acceleration of the system is equal to mu into G. Okay. Mu is taken as 0.3 into g is equal to 10, then 0.3 into 10, that's equal to 3 meter per second square is the acceleration of the body. Okay, acceleration of this system is equal to 3 meter per second square. Okay, we want to find out what about the stopping distance. To find out the stopping distance, we know that b square is equal to u square plus 2as. This is the equation of motion. Here the movement of the body is retarded. Therefore, v square is equal to u square minus 2 into a into s. Okay. What about the final velocity of the body? Initial velocity is equal to 20 meter per second. And what about the final velocity? Finally, the body gets stopped or the car stopped. So, final velocity is taken as 0. Then 0 square is equal to u square. U square is equal to 20 square minus 2 into acceleration. Acceleration is equal to 3 meter per second square. 3 into s. And 0 square equal to 400 minus 6x. On rearranging, 6s is equal to 400. Then s is equal to 400 divided by 6. That's equal to 66.67. Okay, this much meter is the stopping distance. The shortest distance in which the body can be stopped, that is taken as 66.67 meter. Okay, next question. A stone weighing 2 kg and slides on ice with a velocity 3 meter per second is stopped by a friction in 10 meter. The force of friction will be, we want to find out what about the force of friction. For this, a body of mass m is equal to 2 kg which slides on an ice. Okay, which slides on an ice. Okay, 2 kg which slides on ice. With a velocity that is given, velocity v is equal to 3 meter per second and is stopped. Okay, final velocity, initial velocity is taken as u, u is equal to 3 meter per second and final velocity which is equal to 0. Okay, that means the motion is retarded motion. Okay. The stopping distance that's also given, that's equal to stopping distance s is equal to 10 meter. Okay. In this case, we can write mg is the weight of the body which is acting downwards. Okay. If m is the mass, mg is acting downward, reaction which is acting upward, normal to the body. Here the acceleration of the system or retardation of the system is in this direction. Then the force corresponding to that is equal to m into a. Then frictional force which is acting in this direction. From here we can write frictional force is equal to m into a. Frictional force is equal to mu into reaction. That's equal to ma. Mu into reaction r is equal to mg. Okay. That's equal to ma. Or we want to know what about friction. Friction is equal to m into a. Okay. Friction F is equal to ma. Then what about the acceleration of the system? Acceleration of the system can be find out by using the equation of motion v square is equal to u square minus 2as. Okay. Then what about v? V is equal to 0 equal to u square. U square is equal to 3 square 9 minus 2 into acceleration of the system. We don't know about that. A into s. S is equal to 10. Okay. Then on rearranging, 20a is equal to 9. Then acceleration a is equal to 9 divided by 20. Okay. Acceleration of the system is equal to 9 by 20. Then what about friction? Frictional force is equal to m into a. That's equal to m. What about m? M is equal to 2 kg. 2 into 9 divided by 20. That's equal to 2 cancel to 20. It's equal to 10. 9 divided by 10. It's equal to 0.9. 0.9 newton is the frictional force which is acting on that body. Okay. That is the frictional force between the stone and the ice. Okay. Friction is equal to 0.9. Okay. If we want to find out what about the coefficient of friction mu, then we can write mu is equal to, mu is equal to ma divided by mg. Okay. Mm get cancelled. Then a divided by g. Okay. What about the value of a? A is equal to 9 by 20. Then on substituting that value there, then mu is equal to 9 divided by 200. Okay. That is the coefficient of friction between ice and the stone. Okay. If our question is like that, we can solve that. Okay, here the frictional force F is equal to 0.9 Newton. Okay. Next question. How many kilogram of water can a 1 horsepower electric motor pump from a well 200 meter deep in 1 second? Okay. How many kilogram? We want to find out what about the mass of water that can a 1 horsepower electric motor pump from a well 20 meter deep. Okay, the depth of the well is given, depth is equal to 20 meter, and the time t is given, it's equal to 1 second. Okay, for this we know that power P is equal to work divided by time. Okay, here work, that is equal to potential energy. Okay, potential energy, work is taken as potential energy. We want to take water to a height of 20 meter. Okay, then mgh divided by time. Power is given, it's equal to 1 horsepower. 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watt. Then 746 is equal to m into g is equal to 10 into height is equal to 20 divided by time is equal to 1. Okay, from here m is equal to 746 divided by 200. Okay, that's equal to 3.73. Okay, that much kg of water can be pumped out from 20 meter deep well in 1 second. Okay, here 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watt. Then we can solve. Okay, power P is equal to work by time. Okay, by using the equation, power P is equal to work by time. Work is equal to energy. That energy here is equal to potential energy, mgh, mgh divided by time. Then on substituting the value and rearranging, mass M is equal to 3.73 kilogram. Okay. Our next question. A force F is equal to 3i plus 2j plus k displaces a body from the point 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2. Okay, coordinates are given. Okay, what about the initial displacement? Initial displacement can be written as S is equal to S1 is equal to 2i plus 3j plus 1k. Okay. What about the final displacement? Final displacement is equal to 3, 4, 2. That's equal to 3i plus 4j plus 2k. What about the displacement of the particle? Position can be represented as position. Initial position S1 is equal to 2i plus 3j plus 1k. And final position S2 is equal to 3i plus 4j plus 2k. Then what about the displacement of the particle? Displacement of the particle is equal to S2 minus S1, which is equal to 3i plus 4j plus 2k minus 2i plus 3j plus k. 3i minus 2i, that's equal to 1i, plus 4j minus 3j, that's equal to 1j, plus 2k minus k, that's equal to 1k. Okay, then displacement is equal to I plus j plus k. Okay, then what about the work done? Work done W is equal to F dot D. Okay, this is the dot product of force and displacement. Force F is equal to 3i plus 2j plus k. Dot. What about the displacement? Displacement is equal to I plus J plus K. Okay. Then on taking dot product, 3I dot I, that is equal to 3I dot I is equal to 1, plus 2J dot J, that is equal to 2, plus K dot K, that is equal to 1. 3 plus 2 plus 1, that is equal to 6. 6 joule is the work done. Okay, work done in this process is equal to 6 joule. Okay, work then W is equal to F dot D. On substituting the value of force and displacement, we can find out what about the work done. Okay, I think these questions are clear for you. If you like this video, please subscribe and enable the bell button. Thank you.